Hey everyone, how are we doing today? This is James Sweeney, aka SplitSuit, and welcome back to another video. And as part of the Ask SplitSuit a Question series, a bunch of people asked hand history questions. This one actually came privately via email, and Robert just wants me to review this spot with pocket kings. So let's check it out. Okay, so in this hand, we have pocket kings of 5 no limit. It folds around, there's a raise, a poster decides to call that raise, here decides to squeeze. Totally standard so far, except I'd like to see this squeeze probably be a little bit larger, like 80 or 85 cents I think would be a little bit better. Again, at 5 no limit, I assume the players aren't going to have as much discipline, they're going to make more pre-flop calling mistakes, and because of that, when we have our big hands, definitely want to be going a little bit larger. So in this situation, we end up getting called by the poster, and at this point, Robert says, I only had a few hands on him on my HUD, so I had no idea what his 3-bet calling range was out of position. I assumed that it was something like 10s through queens, ace-queen, I think maybe he'd 4-bet kings plus and ace-king, and went from there. Okay, so I'm going to say this about your range analysis, I think it's way too tight. Now, in saying this, I don't want people to think that I'm saying this and I'm like speaking negatively about people that play in the micros. But at 5 no limit, I don't think that the average person is going to have such a tight range calling out of position, even against a 3-bet, unless they've shown themselves to have a lot of discipline. And being that we don't have a lot of information on this player, you know, I really need confirmation to put someone on that tight of a range. So because of that, at this limit, I'm definitely going to put him on something wider. I'm not sure exactly how many pocket pairs it has. I'm not sure exactly how many double Broadway combos it has, but I definitely think it's wider than 10s through queens and ace queen. Okay, so if we operate under that assumption, post-flop's going to be much different. But if we just pause for a moment and look at it, we're involved in a pretty small SPR pot, right? It's 167 in the middle, it's 430 effective, so about 2.6 SPR. And in that SPR, I'm automatically stacking my overpairs. So I pretty much know how to play this situation going post-flop. It's going to be pretty easy. Now, in this exact spot, we catch an 8-high board, pretty connected. And we face a min donk bet from Standu, and obviously this is just a crazy silly bet. And this guy did posting something I usually don't suggest doing. He posted preflop. So he really hasn't done anything great so far. He called an open raise. Okay, well, there are worse things. He called a 3-bet out of position. Yeah, okay, that's probably not the best thing in the world. He then decides to min donk. Well, that's really not something good to do in general. So overall, I'd say this player, even without HUD stats, is probably shaping up to be not the greatest player in the entire world. And again, we're still in a 2.6 SBR pot, which means that I'm still trying to get my stack inside. So I love the fact that Hero's going for a raise. My only issue here is with the size. I'd really like to see this larger. If Standu has something that he's interested in, let's get as much money going in now as possible. Also, if we go to a buck 10 versus, say, a buck 80, do I really think that he's going to like continue with ace-queen either way? Probably not. If I go to 110, he probably folds ace-queen. So really, by going to something like 180 or 185, I think I get continuance from all those pairs that may hate life and draws and all that kind of stuff as well. So I max value from the stuff that he would continue with that's second best. And if he has like a worse hand like ace-high, I don't think he's giving me much action either way. And whatever. It's not like going to 110 gives him a ton of room to think he can jam over the top of me. Not that I think Standu is necessarily even thinking like that. So again, I'm really just trying to max value off all the stuff that is second best. Pocket 9s, pocket 10s, pocket 7s, maybe a draw, maybe 6-7, maybe he gets a little hairy with a gut shot and pair. So because of that, I really like the raise, for sure. And I'd just like the raise to be larger. Now, in this exact situation, we end up getting called. And one thing I'm going to say is we're going to be behind here some percentage of the time, but it doesn't matter, right? It's a small SPR. We're getting it in. Just is what it is. If he decided to make that preflop mistake with, you know, pocket sixes, good for him. With something like 5-7, really good for him, I guess. You know, it works out this one time, but it doesn't matter in the long run. He's going to make so many mistakes by making that preflop call. And even more so when we use the larger size, like I suggested, you know, we just generate so much value in these spots. And even though we are going to lose them occasionally, it's nothing to panic about. Okay, so we end up getting called. Go here, check. Here decides to jam it. Loving this so far. Again, just still getting my stack inside. If he happened to improve with an 8-9 type hand, good for him. Again, if he made that mistake preflop, just congratulations. Sometimes he's going to get there. Just is what it is. And in this situation, unfortunately, he actually had pocket eights. And again, this is going to happen sometimes. Not going to worry about it. But what this tells us is a couple things. One, our preflop range that we assigned, definitely too tight. Again, this whenever you see that, whenever you assigned a range that was tight and then you see something that's like outside of that, you know that you were just giving too tight of a range. And that's okay. We're always going to make mistakes assigning hands, right? And even more so when we're doing it in a small sample size or when someone's an effective unknown, we're always going to make mistakes. What matters is that we learn from it, we refine it, and we make better assumptions going forward. And I think that we can definitely do that here. Again, in general, my big inflection points, pre-flop was the size. I think the squeeze could have been a little bit larger, but post-flop, I like what we're doing. Really more of just a nitpicky thing with the squeeze size, with the flop raise size, but everything else looked good. Again, it's really just the fact that it's a 2.6 SPR pot. We're going to get our stack inside, and sometimes we're going to lose, but in the long run, we're definitely going to crush the spot, no problem. So Robert, thanks for the great hand, and if you or anyone else has a poker-related hand or question, feel free to leave it on our Google Plus page. Leave a link for that in the description box. And also, please make sure to like and subscribe if you're enjoying this type of video. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to let me know. Otherwise, good luck out there, and happy grinding.